Hey guys, Darwesh here. I'm showing a demo of Apollo. Apollo is our electromagnetic wave simulator that we're co-designing alongside Zeus, which is our GPU that's in development. I want to show a demo of Apollo along with a competitor that we have pulled up here. But before I do that, I want to talk about EM simulation. So electromagnetic waves are everywhere. They blanket everything in the universe. If you think of obviously visible light, ultraviolet light, anything in the radio frequency space, X-rays, gamma rays, those bombers that fly around these days that are undetectable, they're undetectable by radar, which is an electromagnetic wave, right? So this is used everywhere. EM is very, very critical to all product development, all scientific research in the world today. So as an example, my phone has to be certified for electromagnetic interference, which means that, you know, maybe it doesn't emit radiation that would damage me, a living person, or an animal, or interact with other devices like in a negative way. So EM is used everywhere. Designing products and finding new frequencies is all, there's two ways to do it basically. One is you do testing, you make a product and you see if it's good, and if it's not, you do it again. The other way is you use computers, supercomputers, to simulate these things. And so one of the areas that we're really interested in, you know, in making a lot faster and a lot more usable as part of Zeus is physics simulations. And so as you guys get an idea, EM is a specific part of physics simulations, and we have found a way to make it really, really fast and much more user-friendly. So before I show the demo, I wanted to talk about three things. The first thing is this machine over here. This is running an FPGA. It's a single FPGA. This is running the hardware that we're going to tape out later this year as part of the Zeus GPU. We're running this at a very low clock speed. It's one engine. It's 250 megahertz. In the chip, we'll have multiple engines, and the clock speed will be much higher. So that's kind of how we get an idea of how fast this thing will be in silicon. This is sitting on the desk because it's small, it's low power, and it's quiet enough to actually serve like at this use case of being on a desk. The competitor benchmarking against is this massive AMD Threadripper machine. What can I say? It's physically massive. It's a 64-core CPU, so it will consume hundreds of watts, and it's quite loud. We use Nacho fans everywhere at Bolt and all of our lab equipment. Just so that like we can have silence. And this is a really interesting case of it's all Nacho fans, everything's air-cooled, it's supposed to be silent, and it's not silent. So we have this down here. We also have hooked up these machines to these power monitors. These power monitors just tell us some useful information about how much power is being used, again, at the wall. This is not a software measurement. This is literally like we plug the power supply into this thing. So we have the Threadripper machine plugged in over here, and on the right side we have the Apollo demo machine plugged in. I will just comment briefly that the idle power of the Threadripper hovers at around 100 to 120 watts. This is important. As we run the simulation, you'll see power consumption increase, and that's how we kind of measure how efficient our hardware and our competitors' hardware and software is. The small form factor machine here, this is like idling at 60 watts. This is actually a mini ITX motherboard, so we try to go as small as possible. The CPU in here is an AMD Ryzen that has an integrated GPU. It's a 6-core. It's tiny. We did this on purpose. Eagle eyes will notice that we have a 1,000-watt power supply. This is just in our lab. If it doesn't consume 1,000 watts, just stuff we have laying around. You know, why not? So I think with that introduction into EM simulation and with an explanation of the hardware that we're showing here, let's go ahead, let's run the demo. What I've pulled up is top on this machine, just to show like that we do have a massive machine, 64 cores, quarter of a terabyte of memory. We're going to run Meep. Meep is an open source electromagnetic simulator, an FDTD solver that is, I think it's developed by MIT as well as a bunch of other researchers. Meep is CPU only at this point. So this is a good example of where the industry is today, is where most electromagnetic simulations are done on CPUs. GPUs are becoming interesting to those users, but for a lot of reasons, it's not really in use today. We're using MPI, which allows us to parallelize Meep over up to, in this case, 64 CPU cores. This gives us the best possible performance without like crazy tuning or anything like that. Lastly, I'll note that we are running this GDS demo. This GDS demo is directly from the MEEP source code. We have not modified the GDS, the Python at all. We're not doing any optimizations. We know MEEP does optimizations on the compute side. We're not messing around with those at all. I'll go ahead, I'll run this. Then I'll run our simulation. Our simulation takes the exact same GDS file and runs an EM simulation on it. So I'll press enter here. You can get guys an idea. There's a commandlet output that pops up. I'll go on to the Apollo machine and I'll run this demo as well. And what you'll notice kind of immediately, the big thing, again, this is the advantage of being able to co-design the hardware with the software, is that this simulation, you know, provides useful output in terms of like the command line output. We can see, we know what fields, what frequencies, all that kind of interesting information, but it's still text data. Like, you want to be able to see, you know, what the simulation actually looks like. It's very intuitive to say, okay, this is this behavior, like across the coupler, is something I'm really interested in seeing. You know, does it work that way? You know, is the electromagnetic wave, is it actually progressing in the right direction I want it to? So being able to see this kind of immediately in a viewer is really important. This to our knowledge, is the first time anyone's ever been able to do this. This MEEP doesn't have this, Lumerical doesn't have this, even for that insane cost. None of the other commercial solvers have the support. And this is really because our competitors, they're building software that runs on existing hardware. They want to use as much of the hardware as possible to do the fastest simulation, right? If you want to build a viewer in or even output data, it reduces the speed of the simulation like significantly. In our case, we've solved for both of those use cases, being able to do a fast simulation as well as actually being able to view it as it's running, because that's really useful. So that's what we've done here. As you can see, when the simulation is actually done, like, it kind of goes around and we can scrub through the view of all of the frames that were outputted as part of the simulation. So this is super cool. This makes a massive difference. If you decide you want to do like a 1 week simulation or something, you don't have to wait the week to see like, oh man, fuck. Like, there's an issue with like the first 10 time steps. That's a massive problem. We want to avoid that. It's a waste of power. It's a waste of time, waste of money. Why bother? So I'm going to run these simulations again. And this time we're going to look at power consumption, because we talked about performance. We talked about usability. These are great improvements in performance and usability. And now let's talk about power. Power is really important. Obviously, we're running out of power everywhere in the world. You know, why would we make solutions that consume more power when we make solutions that consume less power? So that's our thesis here at Bolt, is we can make stuff that consumes less power. So I'm going to run the MEEP simulation, and we're going to take a look at this counter here just to see like what happens to power consumption. So like I said, this idles, you know, 100-120 watts. When I start to run the simulation on MEEP, you'll see that because we're utilizing the majority of the CPU cores, that power consumption does rise. It's a lot of power, 450 watts for a CPU. That's a lot. It makes sense though. It's a 64-core CPU. And once the simulation is done, we see power goes back down to around 100 watts. So it's like 300 to 450 watts is kind of what you expect if you want to do an electromagnetic simulation that takes 12 and a half seconds on a high-end server-grade CPU. We're going to run the same simulation on Apollo, and you'll see a little bit of a different story, which is power does not go that high, actually. And this is the result of the co-design that we've done on both the hardware and software side. As you can see, the simulation is running right now, and power, you know, it's 105 watts. I think this peaks at like 110 watts. So it's, you know, four times less power for essentially the same performance and a much more immediately usable viewer output. Again, this is like a massive improvement in usability, but also being able to do this at speed, right? No difference in speed. And then also at one third the power makes a big difference. Let's talk about the cost of these things. So the first thing I want to say is, you know, we're a hardware company. We're producing GPUs, physical hardware you're going to go buy online or in a store. It's really important for us to make the hardware easily accessible, which means low cost. That's really important to us. So the GPUs that we're building, Zeus, is not going to be very expensive. It's going to be very price competitive with NVIDIA and Intel, AMD, and those guys. But what I do want to talk about is actually the pricing on the software side as well, because you do have to go buy the GPUs. And then you have to go buy, you know, commercial solvers from companies like Ansys, and it's really expensive. So what we're doing is a little bit different. We're not charging for the software in this case, this EM simulator. It is proprietary. But it is included with the hardware. So when you buy the Bolt GPU, you don't need to worry about paying a license for the software. It's built in. And that's because our business model really in the end is we sell hardware and we develop very useful applications on top of it. We work with partners to develop useful applications as well. And it's important that this is remains as accessible as possible. What we're doing is we're opening this up to end users. We were at a conference last week in San Francisco called IMS. A lot of companies came to us and said that if they had the software, they think they would have saved a lot of money, a lot of time. And that's because they're producing silicon today that they can't fully simulate. Imagine that. They're making an RF device, an RF chip, a radio frequency emitting or absorbing chip. And the problem is basically that the existing solvers are not good enough and they're too slow and they're too expensive to be able to simulate like full devices. So they're taping out this chip and they're finding out that, oh shit, we have to go like change this part of the design because we couldn't simulate it. Now we have a device, we've taped it out, we've characterized it, we're not happy with the result. And so, anyone that's watching this video that is designing drones, designing stealth bombers, any medical devices, obviously any silicon photonics device, any RF chip, you guys are using FDTD today. The solvers you're using, we beat them in every way, literally in every way. We're opening early access. Please come sign up, play around with this thing. We hope to see you guys in the early access program. The aim is to reduce the cost of designing a product as well as the time to market for that product.